I hope you're doing well and welcome to this video where today we are going to do a deep dive into the movie Chicken Run Dawn of the Nugget. There are some nuggets in this movie, some secret nuggets, which I think have to do with Christianity, the Bible, and the state of the world today, how atheism is taking over and how sort of ignorant a lot of people are about God and about Judgment Day at the end of days. So stay tuned, we're going to be looking at some music by Katy Perry, we're going to be looking at some old school films, which I actually think this is inspired by, so let's dive into it. So I want to start off by showing you guys a scene in this movie where one of the chickens is watching a video where they're explaining how the farm that they are currently living in operates and why they have come up with the system that they have come up with to farm these chickens.
This is an ordinary chicken. Plain, dull, and easily frightened. Like any simple-minded creature, its natural instincts when faced with processing is fear and panic. When this occurs, the muscles tense, which cause the connective tissues to form knots. The result? Meat that is tough, dry, and flavorless.
Mummy, this meat is tough, dry, and flavorless. I hate you, Mummy.
Oh. Molly.
Fear not, underappreciated mother. Or what if science could change all that?
Okay, so we see in this, we see that we have this farm that want their chickens to not fear being processed. They do not want them to think about being processed because when they do, they become dry and flavorless and they're no good to anyone. So what do they introduce for people to no longer fear being processed? I said people, for chickens to no longer fear being processed. They introduce science. Now they have science, people no longer care about being processed. Oh, sorry, chickens no longer care about being processed. It's funny, it has these googly eyes. So they're sprinkling on this science. And that's what most people have today. A little sprinkling of science. They don't have all the information. They don't have all the concepts that these are just theories, these are just ideas, and that these don't disprove God. It's just a little bit of science. But now we have science, we don't have to believe in a God. But anyway, I'm jumping ahead of myself, but
science could alter a chicken's response to fear. What if it could make a chicken happy to be processed? Then you say, well done, science.
So any Christians out there watching this, you can understand this video because the amount of times we have a conversation with someone about God, their response is, I don't believe in God, I believe in science. So then now they don't think about God because they've had this tiny little sprinkling of science, which in their mind says that, oh, well, therefore there is no God because we believe in science. Like, so now they no longer think about being processed. Now they no longer have to think about the consequences of their decision. No longer are people thinking about saving sex before marriage. They just want to go out and enjoy themselves. No longer are they thinking about the consequences of judgment and taking drugs and getting drunk and gossiping and slander and all these nasty things. They're just like, I don't care anymore. Let me just do whatever I want. And you'll see in this movie, this is what ends up happening. People just live a life of comfort and consumption because of this system that they've made, which makes them completely ignorant to the truth.
Because a happy chicken is a tasty chicken.
This is the most delicious chicken in the whole wide world. I love you, Mummy.
Thank you, science.
Molly? That's a clever little cartoon, Dr. Fry. But will you be able to do it?
So what happens there is a woman comes down, this woman, she comes down and she says, we already have. So he says, this is a great idea. Science making people no longer fear about being processed. You know, wouldn't that be great? It's like, but there's no way that you're going to be able to make this work. There's no way that people, chickens, are going to be that gullible. But yet the woman comes down and says, we already have. And isn't that so true? We live in a world where people, the world has been completely led astray because of this sprinkling of science, which does not disprove God. So let me show you guys another scene. So what happens as a result of this science? What does this system of science produce? Here we have these chickens in this chicken farm where they are now, because of science, they don't think about being processed anymore, and they're happy, and they just consume, and they just live this sort of party lifestyle. So now let me show you a scene where we see what the system now is that now these chickens are no longer fear being processed, and they are very ignorant of the fact of what they're going to be facing. So they've been living this sort of heathenistic lifestyle where they just party, have fun, and they play on all these circus things and they eat and they consume and they play all these rides all day. They're not thinking about meaning in life. Now it's just about consuming. Isn't that the world we're in today? Where people are just no longer thinking about things. They're just thinking about having fun. They're brainwashed like these chickens were. People think that it's the Christians that are brainwashed. It is not the Christians that are brainwashed. Actually, just to give you guys a kind of reference to this, I don't know if you guys ever heard the song Katy Perry, Chained to the Rhythm. It's really interesting, very similar to this movie. There's... Is that everyone's just enjoying themselves, stumbling around like a wasted zombie. They think we're free, but they're not really free, like the chicken run people. And they walk around like zombies in this movie. But this is a song representing us. So comfortable we're living in a bubble, so comfortable we cannot see the trouble. That is the world we live in today with all these people that just don't fear processing. And that was the situation for these chickens. So you can see here that this has that kind of like archetypal idea of somebody facing death. Is that we're all there like our grandma, our mother, our auntie, she's gone to a better place. We see it as, you know, of course when someone dies, if you're an atheist, you know, you get upset. But a lot of people at that point do say, we hope she's gone to a better place. We can't, and this is what it's supposed to look like, right? A stairway to heaven, into this bright light, this tunnel that people go through. What is happening is that the chickens have been brainwashed into believing that one person every now and again gets nominated from a lottery to then go into like a heavenly place, to some special place. And they're like, oh, we all want to be chosen to go. So they think they're going to a better place. They think that in being chosen, which is being processed, they're going to go to a better place. There's a very similar concept in the movie The Island. In the movie The Island, there is also this idea of people being chosen as part of a lottery.
19. Another day in paradise.
These guys have also been brainwashed into thinking that they are that they are living the best life because they've been saved from the world, which is in some sort of apocalypse, and that every now and again one person gets chosen as part of a lottery to go to an island, which is like the final sanctuary, but they can only take a certain amount of people there. And so people are waiting to be chosen for this lottery.
Starkweather 2 Delta, your time has come. You're moving out to the island.
Starkweather 2 Delta here. And as you know, the biggest dream of my life just came true. I mean, I've only been with you guys for like 6 months, but I won the lottery. That's right, me, Starkweather, okay? To go out and breathe fresh air, swim in the ocean, I can't believe I won. You call me Mr. Popular. I know. It's me.
So similar concept, these guys believe that there is this lottery that they all randomly get chosen from and they get to go to this better place. Now let's see what happens in Chicken Run when they go up to this better place, up this tunnel. So you see here, you've got some chickens here trying to save these people from being processed. They think they're going, they think it's all right. They think there's nothing on the other side. Once they die, that's it. There's nothing, it's just darkness. Sad reality is beyond the veil, after they go past the veil, it isn't over. There is a flaming pit that's gonna chop them up. And then you've got some people trying to save them from this, but they're just mindlessly walking straight into it. I mean, this is such a great depiction of, and again, why are they so brainlessly walking into this abyss of a flaming pit? Is because of science. They have been brainwashed by science into thinking that there is nothing to fear, there is nothing after they die, it's just once they go into the light, it's just there's nothing. They don't have to think about anything, just enjoy your life, just have everything, just enjoy your life, be comfortable, live in a bubble, so ignorant, you know. A similar thing happens in the movie The Island. You saw that the people were really wanting to be chosen to go to the island. But then actually what was happening was they had been lied to. It wasn't a better place on the other side. And again, the people were so controlled in that circumstance. They didn't know their left hand from their right hand. They were just following the system that they were given. But the reality was that to win the island meant that they were going to be harvested of their organs. They were going to be cut up.
Let's clean that drip.
Doctor, heart rate's rising.
Heart rate's still rising.
What's his blood pressure?
BP 138 over 92. Heart rate's still rising, Doctor.
What's the anesthetic level?
He's fighting the ventilator.
I don't want to have to euthanize this guy to get his liver.
Stop! Man, this is probably more real than we realize. Because how hellish does that look? Waking up to being cut up, being dragged, being stabbed. And if you guys see the testimonies of hell, yeah, man. Like, guys, you don't want to go to hell. You don't want to be brainwashed by science into believing that you don't have to even think about God. You don't have to even consider being processed. Just enjoy your life. Be brainwashed and play those rides that those guys were playing. Yeah, because they turn up in Funland. And then they're just riding these rides, enjoying their life, completely ignorant of, like, this isn't actually from the movie, guys, just so you know, but this is essentially what was going on. They were on all these rides, just enjoying their life, waiting to be chosen for some, just waiting to die, but not thinking it would just be great. You're just going to fly up into a little thing. You don't have to think about that. It's like this. Katy Perry had it so right. Just keep doing it. Stop thinking. Is this you? Is this how you're living your life? Is this what you want to do? Do you not want to think about God? I know you guys are probably not like this, but it's so interesting, man. I'm just highlighting, like, this movie is just rubbing it in people's faces. And people just are just so ignorant to it. I'm going to show you guys. So, why is the world like this? How has the world got to this state? Why do we live in a world where people are so ignorant, where they are brainwashed into no longer thinking in any way necessary, that there is no possibility of there possibly being a God, that there's no judge, there's no accountability at all for any decision you've ever made? There's, of course not. There's no such thing as right and wrong, good or bad. Just do what you want. It's because of what it says in Revelation chapter 20 from verse 10. And the devil who deceived them was thrown into the lake of burning sulfur, where the beast and the false prophet had been thrown. They will be tormented day and night forever and ever. Why do we live in this world? Because Satan has deceived it. It has deceived it so good. That is why that woman comes down and then she says that it's already done. We've already done it. Satan is saying today, I've already deceived the world. I've already used science to lead people astray so that they no longer fear God. They no longer are worried about what will happen. And I know I am, once they get through that veil, I'm going to cook them up. They're going to be my little chicken nuggets now. They're not gods anymore. I am getting them. They're not going into some angelic light. They're going to be chucked into that flaming pit. It says, will be thrown into the lake of burning sulfur. And ultimately, that is what Satan wants. He wants to take as many people as he can down there with him, because the good news is that is where Satan is going, and Jesus has already won. And this movie depicts that. In the final scene, you see this, and this is the only kind of clip of it I can find, so it's got some weird music and stuff to it, but it's still just the same thing.
Well, now, I suppose you three might make a booking for... Bye-bye. Again.
There you go. Is that you see at the end that Satan gets thrown into the burning sulfur, and so does this lady. I don't know, she's got this weird thing when she rises, but this is what is happening. Satan is going to lose, but he's trying to get as many people into this along with him. So that is it for today. That is our breakdown of this movie. I hope you guys found this interesting. I know this is different, but I've got loads of these. There are so many movies out there that have deeper meaning in it that maybe I'm looking too much into it. I'm not saying that this is exactly it, but you cannot tell me that that is completely coincidental. The depiction of the sun as they're traveling up, you know, like, look at that. Like, this is it. Like, people are just so ignorant that they're all going to have this moment where they die and they're going to be going up into this light. And in that moment, you know, it might feel great, but man, where these people are destined, they're so ignorant. They're so unprepared. And they've got these, you know, Christians out there, these few and far between, trying to stop them from walking straight in to this pit. You know, they're walking straight into a pit. They're going straight into it. Completely oblivious as to where they're headed, because they're so brainwashed as to think that science has disproven God. Like, since when? You know, I've been an atheist all my life that did not disprove there being a God. Like, I can assure you, like, the moment you actually think about it, it's like, well, still, science doesn't disprove anything, you know? You just don't think about it. You're just enjoying your life. You're just these chickens just partying, you know? You just don't think. You just want to enjoy your life, you know? And you just want Katy Perry was singing about. This is us. Anyway, guys, so that is our video for today. I hope you guys enjoyed. Please do like, subscribe, let me know what you think about this video. Hopefully, I've been wanting to make this video for ages. I think this is the second time I've tried to record it. Anyway, guys, I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next one.